Is anyone gonna tell the Vegas Golden Knights that the preseason is over and that these games actually count? Let's go!
Yeah!
I can't even grammar properly right now. How frustrated I am. Golden Knights made history last night. For the first time in franchise history, we have given up 6 straight goals. I know it was only game 2 of the season. I know that. The Golden Knights lose 6-2 against the Los Angeles Kings. My birthday gift from my in-laws was to go to the Salt Lake City game, because I'm in Utah, and let's see. To go to the Salt Lake City game for my birthday, and that was a lot of fun. It was against the LA Kings, and I could not tell you the difference between what the effort was in that preseason game versus the game that just happened. Listen, Vegas is going to have nights off. Any team is going to have nights off. The defending Stanley Cup champion, 2-time champions, Lightning, are going to have games off. They lost 6-3 against the Penguins on the first game of their season. No, it was 6-2. I was right. It's 6-2. Doesn't help that Peterson and Kopitar and I guess Doughty now have the time of their lives playing against Vegas. But it's game 2, right? Why should I care about this piss poor effort from the Golden Knights? Well, they have not shown to me that they can play real hockey very productively. The Colorado Avalanche, that was great. The perfect series for Golden Knights fan, especially because we were still underdogs in that series. The first time that's happened in a while. But Montreal, and I guess before that, Vancouver, showed how to shut down the Golden Knights offense. And if you don't have offense, you can't score, then you're not gonna win games. Leonard, despite allowing, what was it, 4 goals this game? Not on him. It's not. The defense in front of him played super poorly, and we had a line of all rookies with, I'm gonna butcher this, Romberg and Lecision in their first NHL games ever with Krebs in a line, and that line was the most energetic and the most let's do something line in the entire game from the Golden Knights. Vancouver wrote a blueprint. This is how to shut down the Golden Knights. Dallas Stars implemented it well. The Montreal Canadiens perfected it after game 1 of their series last year, and the Kings just did it again. Any team can do whatever this is and shut down. No, I wasn't expecting an 82-0-0 season, but I mean, then my boss texts me because he's from LA, and so Vegas sucks, the cup is ours. Awful game. And it's gonna be more consequential than probably any other regular season game by itself, because not only did Stone get injured halfway through and is out for who knows how long, because day to day could mean months, but also Max Pacioretty it's gonna be out for at least 6 weeks because he has a broken bone. So our 1, 2, and 3, because Tuck had surgery over the offseason and he's gonna be out until February, our top 3 goal scorers from last year are no longer playing for the Golden Knights. LTIR shenanigans, thank you Tampa. We went into the season with more forward depth than ever before in our franchise's history. Not that that's super long, but still, that was really, really good. And on our game 1 against Seattle, we had a D-man playing forward. And in this game, we lost our... We're gonna have to rely on the misfits, and then... We're missing 2/3 of our top line, and the other 1/3 of that being Chandler Stephenson, which, no offense to him, love that guy, he's super speedy, and has played really, really well with those two. Not gonna be a number 1 center on literally any other team in the league except for maybe Buffalo since Jack Eichel's out, and I don't even know who they have playing for them, but I don't even know who we're gonna have playing next game. Good thing we have somewhat of a break to be able to figure this out, but my goodness, this is awful, and I don't know, strap yourselves in. The beginning of the season's gonna be a really rough ride, and hopefully we can still do well. Like I said, this game isn't Leonard's fault. We put Bressois in for the 3rd, and he let in the first shot, which was the power play shot that he faced as a Golden Knight in his regular season debut. Robin Leonard said it best in his post-game interview. I'm not worried, but this should be a red flag. Red flags may include, but are not limited to, allowing 6 unanswered goals. Allowing 47 shot attempts on goal, the most since allowing 49 in our debut season, about less than a month in to the St. Louis Blues, having your top three goal scorers injured, and who knows when they're coming back, not registering a shot attempt on a 4-on-1, which did happen last night.
Oh.
Steve Spott still has his job as the power play coach for some reason, even though our power play was absolutely horrid last year and continues to be this year. What's that saying where doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different result, is the definition of absolutely losing your freaking mind! Yep, nope, I'm done. That's gonna be it for Game 2's nightly review. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good night. Puck is cool though. I liked it. It was really, really cool. It cost $25, but hey. You know?